Time to make risotto. It's wintry, it's cold. I love making this at the end of the day. It's relaxing. I open up a bottle of wine. You need a half cup of white wine anyway for the risotto. And so pour yourself a glass while you're making dinner. And so I've got olive oil heating in the pan, and I'm adding in white onion, finely diced. And we're gonna let that, I don't want it to brown, I just want it to get coated with the oil. And then we're gonna add in the arborio rice. Arborio rice is an Italian rice, and you keep stirring it, and it's creamy. And so it's very specific. You don't sub out long grain rice or short grain rice. It's a very specific rice for risotto. You typically go to a specialty store to find it. So, okay, you just have enough of the oil coating. The onions, they're slightly softened, and I add in the rice. And now I'm going to coat the rice and slick it with the oil. So it's a similar technique to when you're making pilaf, that you want to coat all the grains with the oil. And stir that. You have to keep your spoon moving in the pan so that the rice doesn't stick. It only takes a minute to get them coated. And then I'm going to add in a half cup. Now I have an Italian blended white wine, but it's a wine, so I'm adding in about a half cup. And I cook that in the rice. I'll bring up the heat until that the wine evaporates. So you'll see in the pan, there's still liquid. And you know, with a half cup, I like to just use the wine that I'm gonna drink with. Now it's evaporated, and I start adding in the chicken stock. So I have my chicken stock heated, and I add in a ladle at a time, and this is what I do, and it takes about 18 minutes. And so you just stir until the stock evaporates. And everything else about my meal is pretty well planned out. But I just find this incredibly relaxing. I just think it's really wonderful to just sort of zen-like at the end of a busy day to come home. And you need very few ingredients. And one of the great things, I have a risotto recipe in my salmon book. I did a salmon risotto. You can take expensive ingredients and use a small amount and make it go a long way. So in this instance, I have porcini mushrooms. And I bought these in the market. I did a quick saute. Or you can buy dried ones and rehydrate them in a little bit of water. And if you do that, you want to hold on to the broth. You can strain the broth and use some of that. So as you can see, this is boiling up. This batch of stock is almost evaporated. And I add in another ladleful. And we continue to do that. And everything else is ready. I have cream ready to go. I have a half cup of cream. I have minced parsley. I have a little bit of porcini broth, and I have the porcini ready to go. So we're just gonna let this cook along, and I'll keep adding in ingredients, and then we'll finish it at the end. So I've been stirring the risotto, and it's almost done. I'm gonna add my last ladle of stock, but in this instance, I'm gonna use some porcini broth. And I'm just going to let that simmer for another minute. And then we're going to add in give it a nice color. We'll add in the porcinis. And oh, this looks so good. This makes me just, I love the seasonal flavors. I like how you just move from summer and the peaches and all the berries into fall and all the fall flavors. And how great is this to have mushroom risotto? And now it's at the right thickness that I want to add in my cream. There we go. And we let that cook a little bit longer. Recall the cream doesn't curdle, so you can let it boil away. I'm going to add in a little bit of freshly ground pepper. So I make this in the fall, I make it in the winter. It's just perfect anytime. And add in the parsley. Give it some great flavor. You could even add in a little bit of thyme. Some herbs that relate to the mushrooms, a little bit of sage if you wanted. And then I finish this. And so there we go. It's just going to thicken for just another second. And then I'll finish this with freshly grated parm. And it's ready to eat, and so am I. I'm hungry. Oh, look at that. It's perfect. There we go. Look at that. Does that not look fabulous? All right, let's dish up a bowl. Oh, I can't wait to pour another glass of wine and dip into this. Look at that.